You remember we have worked on operator routing, right? When you have worked on operator routing, an instance can be routed to an operator by using assignment shape, and there you have an option of route to worklist or workbus. Suppose you are routing to an operator. Suppose the operator is not available, means he is on leave for next 1 month. So it should be automatically rerouted to another operator. If that is the business requirement, PRPC has a predefined design for the same. You see here, schedule absences. That operator, what has to do is he has to open his operator form and update unavailable from unavailable to. And when unavailable, substitute operator, you can call a decision tree and return the operator ID, otherwise default to another operator, some other operator. Now, if this operator is not available from this period, the tasks will be automatically rerouted to default assignee whomever you have given. Okay, this is clear. If this has to work while you are routing, there is a checkbox, check availability. If you go to routing option, you will see that checkbox for sure. Check unavailability. If the checkbox is checked, it is going to verify these fields. Let me show you if you want me to show. I'll take one of the assignment and show you. Suppose you go to this assignment, routing is there, right? Route to current user, route to specific user. Custom, worklist, to worklist is the activity, right? Let's say this way. Operator, this is okay. And here you see check availability. There's a checkbox. If this checkbox is selected, it is going to check whether this operator is available or not. If this is not selected, it is not going to bother about whether it is available or not. It is going to route. If this checkbox is selected, it is going to verify whether the operator is available or not. If operator is available, task will be routed to operator. If he is not available, it will be routed to another substitute operator. So, but how that will be done is, in the operator profile, it has to be mentioned like unavailable from to and who is the substitute operator. All this. You want me to give the notes of this? Just hang on. This is done. These are all not implementations that we are doing, but these are functionalities which are ready-made available in program. What is this? How to auto route an assignment to a substitute operator when primary operator is on leave, something like not available, something like this. Okay, after this I'll ask the question. Just hang on. In the operator rule form, we can choose unavailable from. We can, this is OTB available. Open operator rule form. Choose unavailable dates. Choose unavailable dates. You choose unavailable days, choose substitute operators. You choose it. So now the task will be routed to substitute operator. But if it has to work, this functionality works only when we choose below option while routing. While routing, only when you choose this option, it is going to give you this. Here it is. I will give the operator ID here so that you will better understand. Any operator ID it can be, but I'm choosing one that is available there. Okay, look at here. Now check while routing. If we choose the option that is check availability. When we choose while routing, if we check, if we select the checkbox, what is that checkbox? Check availability. VRPC reads the operator forms unavailable dates. Otherwise, it won't read. Otherwise, substitute operator functionality won't work. Okay, this is clear. So this is how VRPC is going to verify operator's availability while you are routing. You have to go ahead and choose that options. This is clear. These are all this get next work. These are all like predefined functionalities that are ready-made, built-in, available in Pega. Okay, so we'll work on further tomorrow. For today, you can wind up. Okay, just go through all this, and we'll go through production rule sets and rule delegation videos, which I have already told you to watch. Also, watch another video